Good morning.
As
the chairperson of the Committee on Ceremonial Occasions, I am pleased to welcome you to the 130th Founders Day Address. Today is an honored tradition at our illustrious and beloved university. It is a day that we set aside to pay special tribute to a great visionary, our founder, General Samuel Chapman Armstrong. Each year, we look forward to this commemorative service when we pause to remember his legacy, his life, and his vision. To begin the program, please stand so that Reverend Deborah Hagens, the university chaplain, will offer the invocation.
Good morning. Please bow with me for this morning's gathering prayer. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praises to his name. We are pleased to tell of your steadfast love. We are overjoyed to tell of your ever-present mercy and boast of your great and wonderful faithfulness toward us. And for these things and so much more, we give you praise. Our Father and our God, today we choose to set ourselves in perfect alignment with your will and your way. For you are our sustainer, our creator, and the great giver of life. We place today's ceremonial occasion of honor and remembrance, commemoration, and faith in your hands, for this is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. Let our program align with your agenda. Let this 130th Founders Day be pleasing in your sight. We give honor to whom honor is due. We remember our founder, who was a soldier, a missionary, a philanthropist, and a humanitarian. Thank God for his life. Thank God for his vision. And finally, we release now, Father, our will into yours and pray your power upon each speaker, participant, and honoree. We leave this moment in confidence and faith that you will see us through. We love and bless your name. Amen.
Please be seated. It is at this time that it's my pleasure to introduce the dais. Please hold your applause until all have been recognized. Beginning on your left, Reverend Dr. Deborah Hagens, University Chaplain and Director of Religious Life. Next, Mr. Novell Dickinson, Assistant Dean to the School of Liberal Arts and Education and the President of the Hampton University Quarter Century Club. Dr. Jeffrey O. Smith, the Presidential Citizenship Award recipient. Hampton University's 13th President, President Darrell K. Williams. Dr. Freeman A. Hrabowski III, Founders Day Speaker, who will be introduced further at a later time. Dr. Joanne W. Haysburg, the Chancellor and Provost of Hampton University. Ms. Margaret Daramola, student poet, English major, class of 23. Mr. Tabas Wilson, Jr., the Student Government Association President. Thank you. At this time, we will have opening remarks from our 13th President, President Darrell K. Williams.
Good morning, everyone. And what a beautiful, beautiful day outside. It's a beautiful Hampton Day is what I would call it. I also want to give special recognition to those joining us online, as well as those that are sitting in the audience. This is the first time in the history of our 130 years of Founders Day celebration that it is being broadcasted live. And so we welcome a much broader audience today. I think, too, that deserves a round of applause. Good morning again, and welcome to the 130th observance of Hampton University's Founding Day celebration of Brigadier General Samuel Chapman Armstrong. However, before I get too deep into the program, I wanted to take a moment of silence, if you will, on behalf of the entire Hampton Nation, to express our collective sorrow over the death of Tyree Nichols and Our most sincere condolences to his parents, to his family, to his friends, and to the entire Memphis, Tennessee community. Hampton University, although hundreds of miles away, stands with the people of that community in this very difficult time. And so I would ask you all to observe just one moment of silence. Amen. Our thoughts and prayers remain with them. And on the occasion of our Founders' Day, we come together to pay tribute and to honor a man whose genius, and I don't use that word lightly, is just as apparent today as it was in 1868. For a man whose vision, whose courage, and determination brought to fruition our beloved Hampton. And it is only fitting that we continue as a forward-thinking institution of higher learning to pause and reflect upon the man who was the catalyst behind what has become the miracle of Hampton today. Our founder was a leader of immense character who possessed a spirit of innovation. Soon after the publication of the Emancipation Proclamation, there was an increased need for educating the formerly enslaved population of this country. And as a result of his direct interaction and experience with black soldiers during the Civil War, General Armstrong had come to believe that black people should not only receive instruction in reading and writing, but they should be trained to, quote, for the demands that a real future was to make upon them, unquote. Along with his supporters, who also believed in this innovative concept, General Armstrong established the Hampton Normal and Agricultural Institute. The Hampton Experience, a training ground for the head, the heart, and the mind of the formerly enslaved people, was a radical idea in its time. Against all odds, General Armstrong worked tirelessly to transform his radical concept into the concrete reality of an institution that has changed the lives of tens of thousands of black, white, Native American men and women, affluent, poor, indeed some that were invisible, and people across this nation and the world. General Armstrong not only impacted Hampton, he in fact impacted the world. In expressing our gratitude for the legacy that he left us, let us reinvigorate our commitment to the work that lies ahead. It's wonderful to think about what has been done in the past, but his real vision is about what lies ahead. Let us emulate General Armstrong's spirit of innovation as we position our beloved Hampton to deliver on its promise of an education for life for all who enter its doors. I would be remiss if I didn't recognize some very special guests today. First and foremost, I'd like to welcome the Armstrong Howe family who are joining us online for today's celebration. I would ask you to give the Armstrong Howe family who's watching from afar, to give them a round of applause, please. We remain so very, very touched. Also, I'd like to recognize Mr. Wes Coleman, the chairman of our Board of Trustees, who's joining us online, and also Mr. Buddy David, who is joining us as one of our Board of Trustee members who's here in the audience. And of course, the beautiful First Lady of Hampton University, Ms. Myra Arma Williams, right? I like to say that she might be your First Lady now, but she has been mine for over 35 years, right? Certainly our guest speaker and Hampton graduate himself, the incomparable Dr. Freeman Hrabowski III, our keynote speaker for today, and his even better half, Mrs. Jacqueline Hrabowski, Miss Gamma Iota Delta Sigma Theta class of 1970 at Hampton University. And oh, by the way, also some of the biggest donors to our university. Let's give them a round of applause, although I know we'll talk to them later. And then our National Hampton Alumni Association president and my friend and his beautiful wife, Stacy, Mr. Willie Williams and Stacy Williams. Thank you all, and all of the members from the Alumni Association who may be here today. Then there's Dr. Jeffrey O. Smith. I know he's been introduced, superintendent of Hampton City Schools. We'll talk more about him later on. The Honorable Bobby Scott. I mused earlier at our quarter of century induction ceremony that he's here so often we think he's a member of the faculty and staff. But sincerely, Congressman Scott, thank you for all that you do for Hampton and for the state of Virginia. To the Honorable Donnie Tuck and his wife, Roby Tuck, if you're here, sir, I believe you are, thank you for attending today. Let's give them a round of applause for the city of Hampton. Also, for the members of the Hampton, Virginia City Schools, thank you for coming. And member of the Hampton City School Board. The Honorable Philip D. Jones, Mayor, City of Newport News, and his fiancee, Jamila Winter, are with us today. Thank you for being here with us today. Wonderful. Also, any members of the Newport News City Council and members of the Newport News City School Board, thank you if you're in the audience today. Special guests today, Dr. Issa Yarasa and his wife Hoda Yarasa. Dr. Yarasa will get a special recognition today. And then the Honorable Mamie Locke is here with us today, and she will also be honored. Thank you for everything you have done for Hampton and that you will do. I would also like to personally recognize the newest members of the Hampton Quarter of Century Club of service to our university, led so ably by Mr. Novell Dickinson. You'll hear more about that today. And so thank you for all of that. To our wonderful faculty, staff, and administrators, none of this Hampton experience would be possible without you. And so from the beautiful grounds that you witnessed when you drove onto the campus today, to the security that's been provided while we're in the auditorium, to the wonderful meals that many of us receive, to the expert guidance and counsel that's given to our students, it simply would not be possible without our phenomenal faculty, staff, and administrators. Please give them a round of applause. Thank you so much. And I will conclude my opening remarks by bragging on our unbelievable students. I know that our founder and all of our past presidents would be extremely proud. Thank you to our entire student body for attending today. Yes, we are honoring our founder, but more so, we honor each and every one of you. You are the current manifestation of the vision that our founder hatched some 155 years ago. And so to our Student Government Association President, Tobias Wilson, thanks for your leadership. To our incomparable choir, which you will hear just in a few moments, thank you for carrying on the rich tradition of the Hampton Singers, which goes all the way back to 1873, when they sang across this nation to raise money, to raise Virginia Cleveland, now Virginia Cleveland Hall. And so thank you to Miss Margaret Darmola, who you will hear, one of our great students, who won our recent poetry competition, where she wrote an original poem surrounding this event, and we look forward to hearing from her as well. And so thank you all for joining us this morning for this auspicious occasion, the 130th celebration of Founders Day at our great Hampton University. Welcome and thank you for attending.
Next, we will have a musical selection, Psalm 150, by the Hampton University Symphonic Choir under the direction of Mr. Omar J. Dickinson.
Thank you.
Let's give them another round of applause. And now we will have special recognitions by Mr. Novell Dickinson, president of the Hampton University Quarter Century Club.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Happy Founders Day. Today I have the distinct pleasure of introducing to you a special group of individuals who have dedicated at least 25 precious years to our home by the sea. Because of COVID, we were unable to have in-person induction for the class of 2021 and the class of 2022. But we know that there may be some members present from those two classes. So if you are, would you please stand and be recognized? Classes of 2021 and 2022. Thank you. Now today we inducted members of the 2023 class. And as I call their names, will each one rise and be acknowledged. Mrs. Margaret Desmond Martin, the Office of the President. Dr. Carmina Sanchez Del Valle, Department of Architecture. Mr. Henry Archer, Department of Physical Plant. Ms. Lothia Boone, Department of Auxiliary Services. Mrs. Phyllis Harrigan, Department of English and Foreign Languages. Ms. Minetta Highsmith, the Office of Development. And last but not least, Mr. Augustus Thompson, Department of Purchasing. Thank you for your service to the university. Now, will all members of the Quarter Century Club please stand and be acknowledged? Thank you. You may be seated.
Welcome to the stage, Dr. Joanne W. Haysbert, Chancellor and Provost of Hampton University, who will read the biographies of our honorees as the president presents them with their awards.
Good morning. Good morning. Dr. Mamie E. Locke, please join President Williams on the stage. Dr. Mamie E. Locke, you served Hampton University with distinction as Dean for the School of Liberal Arts and Education, Professor of Political Science, and Scholar during your tenure, which spanned more than 40 years until your retirement in 2021. Beyond the hallowed halls of the Academy, you also established a stellar career as a public servant to your community, having served as City Council member and Mayor for the City of Hampton, and currently as a member of the Senate of Virginia, representing the 2nd District since 2004. Your long-standing career as academician and public servant extraordinaire have been an inspirational efforts to our students, our colleagues, your constituents, and your fellow lawmakers. Dr. Mamie Elop, given your commitment, integrity, dedication, and accomplishment, and on the authority of President Darrell K. Williams and the Hampton University Board of Trustees, it is my honor and pleasure to bestow upon you the rank of Professor Emerita. Congratulations. Dr. Isai T. Urasa, would you please join President Williams on the stage? Dr. Isai T. Urasa, you served Hampton University with distinction as professor and chair of the Department of Chemistry and Biochemistry, and director of the Water Resources Research Laboratory, which spanned over 42 years until your retirement in 2022. Under your exemplary leadership, the Department of Chemistry garnered more than $30 million in grant funding. As a scholar, you authored or co-authored more than 75 scientific publications and presentations. Additionally, your scholarly accomplishments include an international research training program which established hands-on research for our students and faculty in Kenya, Nigeria, and Liberia over a 14-year period, which allowed more than 120 students to be serviced in those areas. And in so doing, you brought distinction, significant distinction, to Hampton University. Dr. Isai T. Urasa, given your discernible commitment, integrity, dedication, and accomplishment on the authority of President Darrell K. Williams and the Hampton University Board of Trustees, it is my pleasure and honor to bestow upon you the rank of Professor Emeritus. Congratulations. Dr. Hodozaki, would you please join Dr. Urasa on the stage for a picture?
Next, we have Ms. Margaret Deramola, recipient of the Hampton University Student Poet Initiative Award. She will read her poem, Promised Land.
Good morning, Hamptonians. My name is Margaret Deramola. I'm a senior English major with a concentration in creative writing and a minor in history from Bern, Switzerland. Today, I have the honor of sharing a poem with you all entitled Promised Land. From Egypt, the Israelites fled captivity, following a cloud by day and a pillar a fire by night. When the cloud moved, they moved. And when the cloud stopped, they stopped, hoping that one day this cloud would lead them to their promised land. Here we have found our promised land, our home by the sea, once a dream, now a reality. We arose from the shackles of despair to a land flowing with milk and honey. Here we were inspired to become leaders, writers, and freedom fighters. Unleashed from the yoke of yesterday, we sing a song of deliverance unto a hopeful tomorrow. We inhabit the praises of our forefathers, carrying the legacy on our right hand while planting fresh seeds on our left hand. We dream of a new harvest and sing a song of resilience, praising the cloud that journeyed us here today, once desolate, now fertile, once barren, now fruitful. Even through the pandemic, our creativity did not cease to flow. In this hopeless manifesto, still, we found an ending to the abyss. A new era we welcomed, new beginnings we embraced. Yet in the midst of our swift halos, we grieved. Lost precious loved ones, we mourned. Together we lamented, but together also we aspired. Anchored in the midst of the storm, reminded of the ones who paved the way for us to be here today, we stood still. Defying the laws of gravity, we stood strong, we stood firm. Following the footsteps of Booker T. Washington, Thurgood Marshall, and General Armstrong, to be black and educated in America is to carry a badge of honor, an embodiment of the power that runs in our veins, a reminder that truly, all things are possible. To be a Hamptonian to me is a reminder that I can, that here I am, and that here I shall become. This one is for our promised land, our home by the sea. We vow to make thee proud. Thank God. Go Pirates. Thank you.
Such a wonderful talent. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Amola.
At this time, President Darrell K. Williams will present the Presidential Citizenship Recipient.
This is another proud day and moment for Hampton University. Dr. Jeffrey O. Smith, you began your tenure as superintendent of Hampton City Schools July 15, 2015. Under your expert leadership, the division's academic success has reached its highest level of achievement in decades. The division has strengthened its dual enrollment program for the Virginia Peninsula Community College, with students earning 25,443 dual enrollment credits since 2015. The online graduation rate, on-time graduation rate, has increased from 88% of the students in the class of 2015 to 97.64% for the class of 2022. And it gets better, because the dropout rate has decreased from 5.1% for the class of 2015 to 0.62% for the class of 2022. Of significant note, all division schools and centers have achieved full accreditation without conditions since 2019, a first for the division. These meritorious accomplishments earned Hampton City Schools the distinction of being named the first Ford Next Generation Learning Community in the Commonwealth of Virginia. Dr. Smith, you are a firm believer in Hampton City Schools' mission to ensure academic excellence for every child, every day, whatever it takes. As such, you have co-chaired academies of Hampton's operating and steering committees, which have transformed the four high schools from five pocket academies to 16 wall-to-wall academies, and from 18 to 44 offered career paths. The academies provide young learners with experiences and opportunities based on high demand, high wage jobs aligned with regional and statewide workforce data. For this achievement, your work was featured in the 2018 State of the Region report for Hampton Roads as the next generation of learning in Hampton Roads, as well as the Center of American Progress as one of the four models working across the entire United States of America. The class of 2021 was the inaugural Academies of Hampton graduating class. Dr. Smith, your civic engagement is an extended example also of your leadership. As a result of your belief that school divisions are enhanced through strong community partnerships, you've offered your service through board membership to Sentara Healthcare, Smart Beginnings of the Virginia Peninsula, Virginia Air and Space Science Center, Versability Resources, CNF Bank, State Council of Higher Education for Virginia, YMCA of Virginia Peninsulas, and as members of the Region 5 Go Virginia Council. Further, you served as the president of the Virginia Association of School Superintendents from May 2018 to May 2019, and were the superintendent in charge for the New Horizons Regional Education Centers from 2017 to 2019. And you are a 2018 graduate of the Civic Leadership Institute. You served 12 years on the Board of Trustees for the Williamsburg Health Foundation and as both Vice Chair and Chair of the Board of Trustees, respectively. Dr. Smith, you are the recipient of the 2019 Peninsula Humanitarian Award for the Peninsula Chapter of the Virginia Center for Inclusive Communities, and you were named the Region 2 Superintendent of the Year for 2020 Virginia Superintendent of the Year. You were named one of four national finalists for the 2020 AASA National Superintendent of the Year Award. That deserves a round of applause. National finalists. Additionally, you were the recipient of the 2020 Mary Peak Award for Excellence in Education Equity and recognized as the 2022 Martin Luther King Jr. Community Leader by the Urban League of Hampton Roads. Dr. Smith is married to the former Lorraine Samuel of Caroline County, a public school educator herself, and they have two children, a daughter who is a graduate of Christopher Newport University and Eastern Virginia Medical School, and a son who is a graduate of Bridgewater College. Dr. William O. Smith, in recognition of your phenomenal work, your contributions, accomplishments, and myriad successes, it is my honor and my distinct pleasure to present to you the 2023 Hampton University Presidential Citizenship Award. Please join me. Let's give him a round of applause. You may be seated. Thank you.
Let me begin by saying certainly to President and First Lady Williams, members of the Board of Trustees, faculty, staff, alumni, and certainly elected officials and the Hampton University community, let me begin by saying to you good afternoon. Please know that I am humbled and honored to receive the Presidential Award for Outstanding Citizenship. It is with enormous gratitude that I accept this award. As I accept this award, I am grateful for the unwavering support, devotion, and commitment of my lovely wife, Dr. Lori Ann Smith. Please stand. And our children, Lauren and Joshua. Please stand, Lauren. I'm also grateful for the support and the impactful leadership of the Hampton City School Board. Please stand, Chairman and Member Mason and Cherry. City Council and the meaningful partnerships with the entire educational community of Hampton City Schools. What I hope will long remain as a hallmark of my journey in Hampton City Schools is what Robert Frost poetically frames as the road less traveled. It is the road where we believe that all children can achieve. It is the road where we understand that all children are deserving of the opportunity to achieve. And it is the road whereby we accept the responsibility of providing the appropriate resources to ensure that all of our young people are college, career, and life ready. It is the road where we have kept the main thing, our core business of teaching and learning in fulfillment of the mission of academic excellence for every child, every day, whatever it takes. With a clear understanding that there are no shortcuts to excellence. It has been the road which my wife sings about at our church on Sunday mornings, which says, if I can help somebody as I pass along, then my living shall not be in vain. The road of paying it forward. Yes, I shall be telling this, as Robert Frost said, and I paraphrase with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverge in a wood, and we took the one less traveled by, and that has made all of the difference. May God bless each of you as we continue to realize and keep in the forefront of what Nelson Mandela said, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Again, President Williams and the Hampton University family, thank you, and may the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face, the rains fall soft upon your fields, and until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. Thank you.
And now will you please welcome once again the Symphonic Choir as it performs the selection, Walk Together Children. Immediately following the selection, from our choir, the Student Government Association President, Mr. Tobias Wilson Jr., will introduce our Founders Day speaker.
together, children, and don't you get weary. Walk together, children, and don't you get weary. Walk together, children, and don't you get weary. There's a great camp meeting in the promised land. Walk together, children, and don't you get weary. Walk together, children, and don't you get weary. Walk together, children, and don't you get weary. There's a great camp meeting in the promised land.
What if this morning said it would be
meeting in the promised land.
I'm gonna look for me and I'll be gone.
There's a great camp meeting in the promised land.
Going to glory to sing and shout.
There's a great camp meeting in the promised land.
I know the bitter word to turn me out.
There's a great camp meeting in the promised land.
So
walk together, children, and don't you get weary. Walk together, children, and don't you get weary. Walk together, children, and don't you get weary.
I've never been to heaven, but I've been told.
Meeting in the promised land.
The streets up there are paved with gold.
Meeting in the promised land.
A few more risings and settings of the sun.
Meeting in the promised land.
I'm gonna lift my hands for the victory won.
Meeting in the promised land.
So
walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. There's a great camp meeting in the promised land.
So
walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. There's a great camp meeting in the promised land.
We're gonna walk,
we're gonna walk, yes, we're gonna walk.
Good afternoon. Freeman A. Wrubelski III, President Emeritus of UMBC, University of Maryland, Baltimore County, served as president from 1992 to 2022. His research and publications focus on science and math education with special emphasis on minority participation and performance. He chaired the National Academies Committee that produced the 2011 report, Expanding Underrepresented Minority Participation, America's Science and Technology Talent at the Crossroads. He was named in 2012 by President Obama to chair the President's Advisory Commission on Educational Excellence for African Americans. His 2013 TED Talk highlights the four pillars of college success in science. In 2022, Dr. Wrubelski was elected to the National Academy of Engineering, and he was also named the inaugural Ace Centennial Fellow to be served upon his retirement from UMBC. In addition, the Howard Hughes Medical Institute, HHMI, also launched the Freeman Wrubelski Scholars Program worth $1.5 billion to help build a scientific workforce that more fully reflects our increasingly diverse country. In October 2022, he was named the inaugural Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Commemorative Lecture Speaker by Harvard. It is now my pleasure to introduce the 130th Hampton University Founders Day keynote speaker, Dr. Freeman A. Wrubelski.
I want to thank Brother Wilson, who's a member of our fraternity, President Williams. Amen. Just say. I am so touched today. This is the day the Lord has made. And I'm sure your mother told you what Jackie's and my mother's told us. In all thy endeavors, put God first in your lives, and He will direct your path. So I'm going to ask you to pray with me. I'm so moved today by these angelic voices. Look into their faces. You are looking into the faces of brilliance. Give them another round of applause. And I had been hearing about your choir director even before I got here, and I watched him with great dignity, but with power. If you could have seen the chemistry between him and the members of his choir, he could do just little things, and you all knew exactly what he was talking about every time. Yeah, I mean, he was powerful. Give him a round of applause, would you? And as I pray, Mr. President, members of the board and elected officials, the faculty, the staff, the students, people from the community, please bow your heads with me. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. Please pray for me. It is such an honor to be home, at our home by the sea. I come to you as a child of 15 who walked on this campus as a little cocky freshman from Birmingham, Alabama, having gone to jail with Dr. King at 12, having believed that it was possible for tomorrow to be better, having been inspired by the notion of Booker T. Washington with family members who had gone to Tuskegee. I wanted to go to Mr. Washington's school. And I never forget when all of my cousins were going to Morehouse and they said, "You go to Hampton?" I said, "Can't you tell?" Because we Hamptonians know who we are. Give me a round of applause for knowing who we are. Who we are. We are. And that first semester, that first summer, I'm thinking I was the smartest kid that ever lived, and we got the first calculus test back, and I didn't get the highest A, the next A, all the way down to like number 10. I've got tears coming out of my mouth, realizing I'm not the smartest person in the world, but there was only one 100 in the room, and when the professor said, "Coleman, come get your paper," and all of a sudden a girl got up, and she was cute. And I said, "I'm going to marry her one day," and I did. Give her a hand. Get up. And I did. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. So students, if you can't beat them, if they're smarter than you are, marry them. This is a dignified day, and yet I am at home. Samuel Armstrong, this morning, Mr. President, Madam First Lady, this morning when we were laying the wreath, when the president was laying the wreath at the grave of Samuel Chapman Armstrong, I had a thought. Here we were laying the wreath at this wonderful brigadier general, this one-star general, being laid by a three-star black general. Give him a round of applause. He doesn't like my saying that, but I'm going to say it anyway. Anyway, and this was my thought, that as visionary as General Armstrong was, he could not have imagined that one day an African American would be a general and the president of this institution. I want us to celebrate today the idea of vision, of leadership, of excellence. And I want to come to you as a member of that fabulous class of 1970. Give my class a round of applause. Dr. Urasa was a member of that class, smart. And I want you to appreciate Dr. Urasa and his chemistry. We knew, even when I'm coming out of the little southern schools, Urasa was so much better prepared. coming from another country. Yes, and yet he was humble. And we worked together, and through the years, over four decades, five decades. And here's the point, because of his leadership and the other faculty here, Hampton is one of the top builders of life sciences PhDs, African-American, in the country. You're in the top five. It's a big deal because of Dr. Garasa in biology in those areas. But students, I want all the students in the room to stand. Stand up, wherever you are, all the students in the room to stand. All the students to stand, choir members too, yep. And I want you to repeat after me because my theme is what I use all over the country. I used it at Harvard a few weeks ago, and it says that the way we think about ourselves, the language that we use, the way we interact with each other, the values that we hold will be so important. We become like the things we love. And so repeat after me, thoughts, words, actions, habits, character, destiny. Now this time, I don't want you to sound wimpy. It's like you're at a basketball. I want you to have the same passion for education as we have for basketball. And so this time, say it like you are the proud Hamptonian who you are. Thoughts.
Thoughts,
words,
actions,
habits,
character,
destiny.
Destiny.
All right, have a seat. Give a round of applause for the idea. It was our beloved sister Maya Angelou who said, lift up your eyes upon this day breaking for you. Give birth again to the dream. Women, children, men, take it, this dream, into the palms of your hands. Mold it into the image of your most public self. Sculpt it into the shape of your most private need. Here on the pulse of this new day, you may have the grace to look up and out and into your sister's eyes and into your brother's face and say simply, very simply with hope, good morning. Give poetry and that brilliant Margaret a round of applause. So that and here's my message today as we think about who you are. It is that we must soak in the Hampton culture. We must understand who we are. When Sister President Emerita Suber and Jackie and I and many other Hamptonians were at our other alma mater, the University of Illinois, we wanted people to know we are Hamptonians. We're here representing. And when you go out into the world, whether to a company, whether you go to a grad school or law school, you want people to know I am of and from Hampton. And the graduates are amazing. I point up to you, Lord, the younger generation from Rashida Jones, the president of MSNBC. Give her a round of applause. Who would know that an African-American woman, and think about it, she walked to this place just 20 years ago, and now here she is, young woman, the head of MSNBC. You see all the people on TV, she's the power. The power. We're not accustomed to that. Do not take that for granted. And then in my hometown, where, by the way, Jackie's and my mentor, mentee, just became the governor of Maryland, Westmore, give him a round of applause. Westmore, very proud of him. But in that city of Baltimore, there's another Hamptonian who went away to Harvard, to law school. He's now the president of the Baltimore Ravens, Sashi Brown. Give him a round of applause. And I give you those two, there's so many more. But I want you, you should know the names of Hamptonians who are excelling from, think about it, from journalism all the way over to sports. The idea, a Harvard lawyer, Harvard law grad, Hamptonian, who is able to do those kinds of things. Because what it says is, that's what you can do. That's what you can do. And this is what I want you to think about. Going all the way back to the leadership in Samuel Chapman, I want you to think about him as a person, first of all. How unusual it was that a white man would want to help black children. His growing up in Hawaii, his having missionaries as parents. But what he did that you may not know, study his life, was that he led the 9th Regiment of the Colored Troops in the Union. And believe it or not, they were successful in the Battle of Petersburg. They ran the Confederates out of Petersburg. And then he went up and helped with, I guess, General Lee, and they were successful there in Northern Virginia. And then they went to Texas. And by the time they had come back, he had become a brigadier general. Do you know when he started leading with the American Missionary Association? He was only 29 years old. And he stayed here for the rest of his life. And folks, he died at 54. But there is his life. And we celebrate this 130th foundation for this reason. I just figured it out as I was looking at it last night, because he died after that 25-year period. And they began having the Founders Day that next year. So the university is 155 years old, but it was the 130th Founders Day. You get it? I want you to put a human being to that. And then I want you to think about Mr. Washington. Historians got it wrong for many years. Yes, he did teach entrepreneurship. Yes, he did teach about things with the hand, but he also supported Fisk and Clark Atlanta University. My wife and I, when Jackie and I were in Egypt, we studied in Egypt as Hampton students in Cairo. And she got to see the pyramids as a delta. I got to see the Sphinx. It was really cool. When we came back, we were so cool. But here is the deal. The deal is that we got to meet Mrs. Du Bois, Shirley Graham Du Bois. And she was the one who said, I want you to read more, because people always want to pit W.B. Du Bois against Booker T. Washington. She said, no, he had great respect. No, no. And he was funding liberal arts in other areas. And I tell you that because there's nobody who has had a greater impact on the education of blacks in this country, starting with the South, than Mr. Booker T. Washington. Give our Hamptonian a round of applause. And yet, if you think about the founding of Hampton and the idea of teachers, Mr. Superintendent, congratulations. Most of the people coming out of Hampton at the beginning were teachers. Why? Because the slaves, the children of slaves and slaves who came to Hampton, former slaves, needed to learn to read. It was the reading skills. Do you know that today the majority of poor children and black children in our country are not reading at proficiency level? Today we have as big a problem in some ways, given what people need. And so I want all of you to think about whether you're going to be a judge or a lawyer, you're going to be a teacher, you're going to be a scientist, whatever you are, to think about the next generation. Because when we talk about letting our lives do the singing, it is about the service that we give. It's not about being snobbish. Yeah, we're one of those black Ivy Leagues, all that, and that's all wonderful, the generations here, but we serve. To lead, as your president will say, is to serve. And the other presidents who came after that, the president for us at Hampton in the 60s was Brut Holland, who had been All-American but came from Cornell. And he went on to become the ambassador to Sweden. Imagine how we, young black kids, coming out of the civil rights movement, seeing. And then I want my brothers and Alpha. It was in 1968. We're pledging Alpha. And what happens? Martin King is killed. Reverend King is killed. All we could do was cry. And those of us from the Deep South cried even more deeply. And I tell you that because I think about that 29-year-old who founded Hampton. And then I think about that 20-year-old young man who was killed by those police officers recently, who didn't get a chance to see his vision. And what is my point? That we have made progress, yes, but we have so far to go. That we must not be lulled into being satisfied because a few of us have been educated. Your being educated is a big deal. Do you know that when Jackie and I were here at Hampton and Urasa, the fact is only about 4% of blacks had gotten a college degree. 4%. Today we're up to about 30% of blacks, 40% of whites, 20% of Hispanics, Native Americans below that, Asians a little more. But what is my point? Most Americans still haven't gotten a college degree. And for us, the point is to go to a Hampton, you must be able to read and think. I get goosebumps doing math. How many of you like math in the room? Oh, it's a pretty nerdy group. Very good, very good, very good. I came here and I learned I was not the smartest, but I learned, but I could work with the smartest, the ones who were the hardest working, who had a better preparation, and to dream about the possibilities. And that's what I want you to think about. So going from President Holland, who went on to be ambassador to Sweden and the first black on the stock board, New York Stock Exchange board. That is huge, huge. That was a Hamptonian, that's a person who had been president of Hampton. And then our beloved William Harvey, who started scores of programs, 29 29 buildings and took the endowment from $29 million to $400 million. Give William Harvey a round of applause. Round of applause. The president, President Williams and I were talking last night about Hampton, and it was President Williams who said, but we must give President Harvey that due for that 40-some years. And so I tell you about the leadership from all the way from Samuel Chapman Armstrong through some white presidents, finally the first black, and then Bud Harlan, who was there, to then Bill Harvey, and then today to have our Hamptonian, the first Hampton couple. Hampton couple. Give them a round of applause. You know, Jack and I, as young president and first lady, learned from Bill and Norma Harvey, and they were wonderful to us. And we're so delighted to be here with this couple of great dignity. Give them one more round of applause for who they are. And here is my message to you, that Hampton is about our dreams. It is about the fact that we can come from Tallahassee, Florida, and Birmingham, Alabama, and other countries, and dream about the possibilities of what we might do. Students in the choir, students out here, I'm telling you, if I can do this, you can do this. Whatever it is we have accomplished, we accomplish it through faith in God and through help from so many other people. And so I challenge you to keep thinking about, who am I? What is my story? Who is it I'm doing this for? To whom can I pay it forward? And think about when they said, what is Hampton? It's the water, it's the home by the sea. It is the music, my God, who cannot, you cry when you hear this, the singing, and you hear these brilliant young people with their voices. If you want to know heaven, be around on the day of commencement when the choir is practicing and the music is coming out of the trees. I'll never forget, I found myself walking around thinking, this is about as close to heaven as I can get. And that is Hampton. But the artwork, and we think about Henry Oswald Tan and the dance and the culture, and then studying in the sciences and in the social sciences and producing these leaders. You are the next leaders, remember that. You know, my dream after leaving here, after learning about grit, the word we talk about at UMBC, hard work, perseverance, never giving up. When we got to Illinois, some days, the only black I would see would be a pretty little brown face, my new wife. And I would say, my Lord. And all of a sudden, my dream became, how do I help our country understand that we need more people of color, more African Americans and others, who are not just loving math and science, who become the best. And so Hampton taught me to dream about the possibilities. And so when I tell you that my campus that I've just left is the number one producer of African Americans who get PhDs in the natural sciences and engineering, that's what I'm talking about. Give my campus a round of applause. That's what I'm talking about. And you know, how many of you have had that vaccination? I hope everybody, right? That young black woman who created the first black woman of any black woman in the world, with the Moderna vaccine. I recruited her from North Carolina when she was 17, from a little country town. She went on, led the team, produced the vaccine, now I'm the faculty at Harvard, and we are alive because of that young black woman. Give Dr. Kismikia Corbett a round of applause. You know, when I was here, young people, a futurist said to us on one occasion, the day will come when every one of you will have a phone in your pocket. And I'm being the little cocky kid I am. I get up and I say, I can prove to you through maximization and minimization math problems, Urasa, that it can't happen because there aren't so many lines that you can have coming out of people's pockets before you're all confused. What was my problem? I hadn't even thought about the possibility of wireless. How many of you are old enough to know that when your phone was in the house, it had a cord attached to the wall? You get what I'm saying? Here's my point. Young people, as much as I talk about the science and technology, it will be the humanities and the social sciences and the arts that will teach us to ask good questions, to not just give up on things and to think technology rules us. that will teach us what it means to be human. And so I challenge you to watch your thoughts. They become your words. Your words become your actions. Your actions become your habits. Your habits become your character. Your character becomes your destiny. Young people, Hampton, you are so special, and you can be even better. God bless you all. Thank you. Here we go. Thoughts. Thoughts. Words.
Words.
Actions.
Actions.
Habits.
Habits.
Character.
Character.
Destiny. Young people, get off your feet. Get up. Stand up. Son, I love you. Stand up. Stand up. Get with me. Get with me. We ain't cool around here. We about it at Hampton. Here we go again. Thoughts.
Thoughts.
Words.
Words.
Actions.
Actions.
Habits.
Habits.
Character.
Character.
Destiny.
Destiny.
Here's your test. Watch your thoughts. They become your...
Ah,
some of y'all know it, and that's my last message. Be mindful in your classroom. Be mindful. Listen carefully. Go around this campus and understand the history. This time, we're going to repeat it and then the test. Thoughts.
Thoughts.
Words.
Words.
Actions.
Actions.
Habits.
Habits.
Character.
Character.
Destiny.
Destiny.
Here's the test. Watch your thoughts, they become your
words.
Watch your words, they become your
actions.
Watch your actions, they become your
habits.
Watch your habits, they become your
character.
Your character becomes your
destiny.
Hampton. Thank you. Say, without my wife, I am nothing. Give Jackie a round of applause. She is my rock.
So in case you all were wondering, that was an award that we're giving from the alumni, designated him or reinforcing his position as one of our most distinguished alumni. And so that's why Brent Martin was on the stage with us. And so what an inspiring message. I think we all got something from it. And so let's give Dr. Freeman Hrabowski III one more round of applause. Just absolutely inspiring. And so as I go to closing remarks, I will just end where I began with a focus and a thought about our beloved founder, Brigadier General Samuel Chapman Armstrong. This is a day that honors him. And the fact that you all are sitting in this audience and on this beautiful campus that he started, and the fact that every generation of Hamptonian that has ever been on this campus has walked somewhere between the Emancipation Oak and this location is something that we should all be very, very proud of. And so those tens of thousands of Hamptonians that are still alive and walking all across America and making contributions to our world, we want to say thank you. But we owe it all to the vision, the character, the grit, and determination of one man, Brigadier General Samuel Chapman Armstrong. And so for the 12 presidents of this university that preceded me, I am proud to continue that legacy. And in terms of continuing the legacy, as Dr. Hrabowski said, a cry to the young people that are in the audience today, that legacy is extended by each and every one of you. And so while you might have been inspired today, It will really be done by you allowing your lives to do the singing when you leave this great university. And so to everyone in the listening audience and here in the audience presently, thank you for attending today. Congratulations to all of our awardees today. Would you give them one more round of applause, please? And so I'll end by simply saying, may God bless Brigadier General Samuel Chapman Armstrong and the vision that he had and his family that is joining us online. May he continue to bless this phenomenal university. May he continue to bless each and every one of you, and may God continue to richly bless the United States of America. Thank you so much, and happy 130th Founders Day.
And now, would everyone please stand?
Please stand. One thing that I wanted you to do right now, that I wanted all of you, the students, to know. Okay. It's typical of me, I'm sorry. But it's from my heart, as they said, and it's very important that I say this. Some of you may know this, some of you don't, though. The words of the alma mater, Jack and I were studying this coming down here. The words of the alma mater were written by an amazing black woman, a Hamptonian. Her name is Sarah Collins Fernandez, students, Fernandez. And I want you to look her up. She literally wrote those words in 1882, all right? As an undergrad, she was finishing undergrad school. The music did not come until 1927. And it was written by an amazing guy, Chauncey Scott North, a Northern, who went on to Juilliard in voice, became a voice teacher at the Carnegie Hall for the rest of his life. He died in 1990, and Sarah became an amazing social worker. Look her up, and what they let their lives do the singing, but I want you to personalize the alma mater to know there were people who wrote that, who believed it, and lived it their lives. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Wazowski. Thank you. And now, will everyone please stand as we join the Hampton University Choir and sing the alma mater. Afterwards, please remain standing for the benediction by our university chaplain, Reverend Deborah Higgins, and that will conclude our ceremony.
now unto him who is able to keep us all from falling and to present us without faults before his throne with exceeding and overwhelming joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, now henceforth and forevermore. And as always, God, over your people, let your love, your joy, and your peace, your power, your protection, and God, your constant provision, your Holy Spirit, your holy anointing, and your holy presence that gives us all so much joy, Father, let it rest, let it rule, and let it abide over the lives of these, your precious believers. In the name of the Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen.
Go, class of 1983. Radiance, bring in the heat. Go, Radiance.
This concludes our program. Thank you for coming.